the 8 o'clock starting time, representing the University of Georgia, Greyson, Sigg. University, Matt Gilchrist.
Welcome to the opening round of the 2016 Southeastern Conference Championship. As you can hear, the wind is already blowing here at Sea Island Golf Club. Greyson Sigg is piped his drive on the right side of the fairway as his second shot. Winds out of the northeast, so this hole should be playing back into the wind. Last time Greyson was here, he finished runner-up at the State Amateur Championship. Lost to Drew Love in a five-hole playoff. And the second shot went long and right and pitched it to this position. So this is a par putt to avoid an early bogey. Not the start Greyson was hoping for. 53 holes left. This, unfortunately, is a bogey putt for Greyson Sigg at the first. Falls to one over par early on. Greyson now on the tee at a 415-yard par 4 second hole, coming off bogey at the first. It's won twice this season. Pebble Beach and the Southern Intercollegiate in Athens. First two wins of his college career. Outside chance of a birdie here to reverse that drop shot. Greyson 17 off of the par 3 third. Tee markers have moved up. Normally plays 204 yards. Grayson's putting for birdie here at the third. He hit the closest tee shot of the three guys in this group. And this is the first green he has hit in regulation so far. Just to get back to even par. And that's a rare birdie on number three, especially in these wind conditions. Sigg going off the birdie at the third. Al-B-FORE off the 429-yard par 4 fourth hole. Second shot for Sigg, fourth. He has hit all three fairways in regulation, but only one out of three greens. This is his approach shot. Appears to be right at the hole, maybe a little long. Let's see when we get up there, green side. Greyson for back-to-back birdies. This is at the fourth. And then walks over to the 409-yard par 4 fifth hole. Going through his yardage book. And now figuring out which way the wind is blowing, which should be from the northeast. Could blow as much as 25 to 35, perhaps even 40 miles an hour earlier today. And Sigg at the fifth. So this stays on the left side of the fairway. So he is perfect in fairways and regulations so far today. 4 for 4. This pin is over here on the right side. hole. A little long. I left three birdies. Excuse me, two birdies in the last three holes. Makes that. It's really beginning to howl here. It's sea on the seaside. There's the tourist causeway in the background, which makes you from Brunswick over here to St. Simon's Island, where we are. The SEC Championship, Greyson Sigg has a chance to make two birdies in the last three holes. This is here at the fifth. And he'll stay at even par, which at the end of the day will be a great score. Heck, maybe even enough to win the championship come Sunday afternoon. It's the tourist causeway again. That long bridge. Grayson will head off to the par 3 6 hole, then par 5 after that. Grayson now on the tee at the 179-yard par 36 flags on the far left side of the green. As the sun begins to shine here on the seaside course, as this long where you put it to 6, get it into mid figures for the championship. This is here at the par 3 6. Well, after missing the first two greens, Grayson has found the last four greens in regulation. Hit every fairway in regulation. Sigg from par 6. Grayson Sigg now on the longest hole on the seaside course, 582-yard par 5-7. That's a great par save back there to 6. Pigeon is going to play his approach shot to number 5-7. I imagine this is probably going to be a layup for Grayson. Greyson, seventh, par five, flags on the right. Gotta guard against going long here. Says marsh, long and right of the green. Left of the hole. Trying to spin ever so close to the hole. Birdie chance for Greyson. Greyson staring down the birdie putt here at the par 5-7. This will get him under par for the first time in this championship. He's hit the last five greens in a row in regulation. That slides on by. Only two par fives here on a seaside course. The 7th and the 15th, which is on the other side of the marsh. For Greyson at the 7th. He stays at even par and heads to the short par 4 8th hole. Sigg now teeing off at the 368-yard par 4 8th hole. As you see right there, that sign. Greyson's working on four straight pars since the birdie at the 3rd. Started with a bogey at 1. It's even par through 7. Greyson's approach to the 8th, 368-yard par 4. Second shot plays uphill, flags on the left. A little short, actually, well short. That'll be a long 2-putt from there. This is a very long birdie putt for Greyson Sigg here at the 8th. If he were to somehow make this, he would get to one under par. fifth par in a row. Yeah, that's a huge two putt. Greyson at the 452 yard par 4 ninth, and the wind all of a sudden has really strengthened here. I believe it's playing downwind, maybe a little from the left. Hazard on the right hand side and the bunker on the left side. He has hit every fairway so far on his first nine. Trying to make it a perfect 7 for 7. Second shot for Greyson, and he has hit all 7 fairways. Short of the green. He has his birdie putt to get to 1 under also. Woo. 1 under par, 34. Good, huh? Yeah, in this windy weather. And waiting for Zach Healy's group up front to clear the fairway. At 418 yard par 410, there's a water hazard left of this fairway, which you can't see from back here. A fairway bunker to the right. 7 out of 7 fairways hit today. 7 out of 9 greens. And only 15 putts through 9 holes. He's 1 under par, going up to 34. After a backup due to Zach's group, here's Grayson's second shot. Just missed a fairway to the left. His first miss today. Flag is on the right side. And that appears to be left. Up the hole. I'm starting to get some mist and drizzle falling here on the seaside course. As well as a continuation of, at times, some fairly strong winds. Pretty Greyson for birdie to 10th to get to 2 under. This will be 2 in a row. Greyson has this short par putt to stay under par at 1 under. He too misses a short putt. 3 putt bogey for Greyson, first 3 putt today. Jumps him back to even. Greyson Sigg, 425-yard par 4, coming off a 3-putt bogey at the 10th. Seems not happy about. Despite that, drop shot, even par is not a bad score today. And Sigg playing his approach to the 11th. Flags on the left. Doesn't sound too thrilled about that shot either. Greyson has yet another long birdie putt. But it falls, he would get back to 1 under. Coming up. Yeah, I can't either. Again, that's a short par putt. Back-to-back bogeys for him. Hopefully not for Greyson. Stays at even par. Back up on the par through 12 hole. 312, and he's got a fairway medal in his hand. Possibly a 5-wood, flags on the left. Kings Creek and Marsh short and left. So no go. Longest par 3 on this course. It's not a bad score. Greyson has reached a tee at a 408-yard par 4, 13th. Golden opportunity missed back there at 12. Driven a rare birdie. Fairway out of 9 so far. Greyson plays approach to the 13th. Looks like it's a left of the hole. Another one of those lengthy birdie putts for Greyson. This is a birdie putt for Greyson Sigg at 13. It's back to 1-under, and there is a backup on the 14th tee. Third birdie of the day for Greyson. After this long wait, Greyson now finally getting ready to hit his tee shot here at 442-yard par 4, 14th. Last check is playing as the second hardest hole on the golf course right now, averaging 4.64. No birdies recorded here yet. And playing into the tee for this northeasterly wind. There's also been no birdies to do on the 16th, 17th, nor 18th holes. And then the 15th to par 5 is playing over par, playing tougher than the 7th right now. So a tough finish coming up for these guys. Grayson's coming off of a birdie at 13, which that last check was playing the easiest hole on the golf course. Michael Johnson and Lee McCoy's group and the group behind them are also waiting on his tee. Second shot here to par 4, 14th. Call this hole almost unfair the way it's playing today. Could move the tees up. Some markers were moved somewhat forward, but they were still on the back tee. Nonetheless, it's his second shot. He has found yet another fairway. Cannot miss left. And that's not a bad shot. It's actually a great shot. But no birdies recorded here at 14 today. Maybe Greyson will get the first one. Greyson for a rare birdie here today in this par 4, 14th. 42 yards into the northeasterly wind, and also for two in a row. Wow, getting away from them. Jeez. Got some work to do to save par here, which would probably feel like a birdie today. Even. Good news, par 5 coming up. Fairway and still makes 5. That's how the hardest hole is playing today. Grayson's yards to 565 yard par 5, 15th. Normally plays as the easiest hole on the course, but not today. Thank you. Greyson has a long break on here. He's on his third shot from sand and back with the slope. This reaches the 407 yard for 16. Second shot for Sigg at 16th. Just off the fringe here at the 16th. Still back in the red figures for the championship. And see at the 16th. Reached at 192 yard par 317. Pins on the left side. Should get it hooking too much, you might find a water hazard off of this green. A couple of greens and bunkers short and right. once again from the fringe. Has he birdie putt this time? Look at par 3, 17. It's Grayson's fourth birdie of the round against three bogeys. Two of those, three putts. Grayson's 470-yard par 4 finishing hole. It's the toughest hole on the course in last year's SEC Championship. Still only missed one fairway today. Very impressive in these windy conditions. This was a big drive for Grayson Sigg, 18th. This is what he was off for a second shot. Flags on the top. Has a putt for birdie and a round of 268. It's also for back-to-back birdies. It's already the 17th. Under 69 in a few moments. Sigg for par and around a 1 under 69. Goes up in 34, comes home in 35. Nice playing in these conditions.